Hi, this is Gary with MacMost.com. On today's episode, let's take a look at text-to-speech in iOS 8. So to enable the text-to-speech functions, you want to go into Settings and then under General, go to Accessibility and then Speech. And you have three options here. Now the first one we've already had available in previous versions of iOS, and that will allow you to speak a bit of text that's selected. The new thing is Speak Screen. We're going to turn that on. Now when any of these are on, you get to choose things like the voices, and you've got various languages, but also inside of English you've got various different forms of English plus quality. So I've set it to 1 there. I don't see much difference between the quality ones, but presumably there is. Then you get to set a speaking rate and you'll be able to adjust that on the fly. And then you can turn on or off highlight content. And it's actually useful to kind of have the highlight content on if you want to follow along with the speaking. So now we've got it on, let's try it out. So here I am in the Notes app and I'm going to tap to select here, select all, and you can see now in addition to copy and paste and other things, I have a speak button.
This is a test note.
Alright, so now let's test the speak screen function. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to put two fingers above the screen, so about where the camera is on the iPad, and I'm going to drag down onto the screen to about halfway down. So I'm not starting my fingers on the screen, but above it and dragging down.
This is a test note.
So you can see not only did the text get read, but you also saw those buttons appear that allowed me to pause the reading or speed it up or slow it down. So if we try this with a web page, we're typically going to get more than we bargain for. For instance, this web page is going to read everything at the very top.
Mac most, get the most from your Mac, iPhone, iPad, iPod, and Apple TV, video tutorials, news and insight.
So you see it's reading everything in the navigation bar at the top. That's not what we want. We want to read the article. So Speak Screen works really well with the reader mode in Safari. So we can get into the reader mode by tapping on those lines just to the left of the URL, just to the right of the bookmarks bar. This will only appear on news articles, blog posts, anything that has a lot of text in it. We tap on that and now we're in reader mode. Now if we use the Speak Screen function,
MacMost weekly newsletter. As the pendulum sways from PC to Mac, I have found the MacMost new.
So you can see now it's going to read just the stuff that we really want. So using the reader mode with Speak Screen works really well. Now here's a feature a lot of people have been waiting for. You can use Speak Screen with iBooks, and it actually works really well with iBooks because not only will it read the text, but it'll even flip pages for you. So here we are in a book. Let's start the Speak Screen function.
Alice's Adventures in Wonderland. Chapter I. Down a rabbit hole, Alice was beginning to get very tired of sitting by her sister on the bank and of having nothing to do. Once or twice she had peeked into the book her sister was reading, but it had no pictures or conversations in it. And what is the use of a book?
So you could see there it flipped the page for you. So basically you can turn just about any book, especially novels, into audiobooks. So let's take a moment here to look at the special functions. You can see that it shrinks over to just a dot on the left if you leave it for a while. But you have the ability to move forward and back, and you can play and stop, and you could slow down and speed up.
Pictures or conversation, so she was considering in her own mind, as well as she could, for the hot day made her feel very sleepy and stupid.
And you could just dismiss it with that X, and you can shrink it over manually with the left arrow there. So there's a lot of functionality that you could do. Now this is certainly not good enough to replace audiobooks. Frequently words are mispronounced or the wrong version of a word is used. Like for instance, the pronunciation live for L-I-V-E instead of live seems to always be used, and that's kind of confusing when reading some text. But it's a good alternative when there's no audiobook available or when it's something short to read like an article or web page. Hope you found this useful. Till next time, this is Gary with MacMost.com.